Welcome back to the Sixth Gear Garage. Today, I'm going to do a side-by-side comparison test of this 200-watt pulsed laser cleaning machine against this 2,000-watt continuous wave machine. And I'm going to be using it on these three different products.
And these are the items I'll be cleaning today. I have a piece of sheet metal from a door, a much thicker, rustier steel bracket, and an aluminum swing arm that's been powder coated. And we'll see what the 200 watt pulsed machine can do first. Here's a look at the parameter settings I'm using on the 200 watt pulsed machine. There's a lot of layers on this old door panel. Under the dark blue is a maroon layer, then a lighter blue, then primer, and finally the bare steel. So it's taking a little extra time to get through all those layers. By the way, who can guess what kind of vehicle this door panel is from? Post in the comments and I'll let you know if you're right. An entire door panel isn't the ideal application for a 200 watt pulsed laser. I mean, you can use it and it will turn out great. You're looking at an hour or so of laser cleaning when most of these areas in this door could be stripped with a sander in less time. I use it to strip a firewall, which has a lot of raised and recessed areas that I couldn't get to with the sander, and it was perfect for that. Or the 2000 watt continuous wave laser is ideal for large items like this, which we'll see in a little bit. Here's a close look at the surface. Nice clean metal with no discoloration, so you know it didn't get too hot. Those lines you see are from the edge of the beam. They're actually smooth. And there's a setting called edge factor that I can adjust so it doesn't leave those edge lines. Now let's see how it does on this heavy rust. I'm using the same settings as before. This 200 watt pulsed laser I'm using is the FLC200 by Fortune Laser. I bought it a year ago and it's worked flawlessly and saved me so much time on restoring parts. I made a full video about this machine that I'll put a link to in the description if you're interested in learning more. Here's a close look at the rust. And it has been completely removed. Even the pitted parts are fresh, clean metal. Scaling rust can be an issue for the FLC200, like the time I tested it on an extremely rusty frame. The rust was removed, but then underneath the scaling, there was still more rust. But cleaning up surface corrosion and light pitting like this is no problem for this machine. On the back side of this panel, it's covered with some kind of rust preventer or undercoating. I'm still keeping the same settings as earlier. 100% power, rectangle 2 mode, 500 frequency, 12,000 speed, 500 pulse, and 20 millimeter width and height. The laser has no problem removing this thick material. Again, if I was stripping a large panel, I probably opt for the 2000 watt continuous wave laser here. Here's a close look at the clean surface. And you can see a little bit of discoloration. I had the laser there for a little while and it did start to get hot. Next up is this heavy steel bracket. And this is super rusty. Looks like it's been coated with multiple coats of white paint. White is the most reflective color, so lasers can have a hard time with it. Let's see how it does. I'm still using the same settings as before, and you can see how much longer it's taking for the laser to get through this white paint. But with some extra time, it does cut through the white paint, leaving a clean surface. Let's try it on the other side where there's bare steel and no white paint. I don't know what kind of paint this is, but it's extremely resilient. The bare surface was cleaned in a couple seconds, but the paint is still hanging on. The laser is just starting to break down the thick white paint. Here's a close-up. Look at the cleaned surface. Notice that there's an extremely fine etch pattern left here by the laser. This is a great surface texture to give new primer and paint something to bite to for better adhesion. Different settings on the machine can leave different patterns, but we're on the border of scaling rust with this one. So let's give it some scrapes with a sharp chisel. And you can see that there was some very fine scaling that I'm scraping off to expose additional rust underneath. Here's a close-up look, but it's nothing close to what I showed on the rusty frame. We'll see how the 2000 watt continuous wave machine handles this in a little bit. Now for the aluminum swing arm. A few areas are bare, the rest is a light silver powder coat. Someone actually started to sandblast this and quit because it was taking way too long. So this must be some really thick powder coating. I have used this machine to strip powder coat a couple times before, and this time the result was completely different. I don't think it had anything to do with silver being a light color close to white, because that would just take some extra time, and this is going pretty quickly. But for some reason, the laser is burning off the powder coat and leaving behind this burnt on goo that I have never seen happen before. I'm not an expert in powder coating, so if anyone knows what's happening here, please let me know down in the comments. It's almost as if this powder coat maybe had some kind of rubber content or something to make it a little on the softer side, maybe to make it more resistant to chipping. That's my best guess. And that also explains why someone had such a hard time sandblasting it compared to other powder coats. After a minute of cleaning, there was still some burnt goo on the surface. This is weird, guys. Get a close-up look. It left some kind of residue on the aluminum. It does scrape off easily, but I've never had that happen before. Maybe this is some kind of special coating. Here's another one I did the other day. This one was powder coated black. Used the pulse laser on this, and you can see the bare aluminum is completely clean. You have removed this just like any other paint I've ever removed. All right, we're going into cycle ring mode. I think this one's the most aggressive, and we'll bump up the speed to, say, 20,000. See if we can zap this off. The cycle ring mode did leave a somewhat cleaner surface than the rectangle mode. And after a second pass, any remaining residual crusty gunk was removed, leaving a clean aluminum surface. But with whatever kind of coating this is, cleaning this entire swing arm would take well over an hour, maybe two by the time I stripped all the nooks and crannies. Here's a close look at the area I really focused on, but everything else still has this burnt residue on it. And you can see it's not rubbing off. So I'm gonna stop here and we'll revisit this with the big boy FLC 2000 over there. Look at the width compared to the pulse machine. Continuous wave machines are ideal for large surface areas, but the surface receives constant exposure from the laser because it isn't pulsed. So there is a potential to overheat thinner metal easier, which can lead to warping. Luckily, this door skin from 1979, oops, there's a clue if you didn't have a guess, this is way thicker than the newer import panels I'm used to working with. So there was no problem with overheating or warpage here. While it did clean the surface, it took longer than I expected because of all the layers of paint and primer the laser had to burn through. It didn't leave a 100% clean surface like the pulse laser did. This primer, or filler, whatever this is, pretty much scrapes off now. I did spend less time on this lower area. And you can see there's a pretty heavy etching left here compared to the pulsed. Looks like it got a little hot here. Really heavy lines in a metal surface from the 2000 watt continuous wave machine. Okay, if you're planning on priming and painting, may need some filler primer though. Here's a perfect demonstration of the speed of the continuous wave versus the pulsed machine. 23 seconds to clean almost half of this panel versus 30 seconds to clean the small area with the pulsed machine earlier. Here's a close look. There are definitely horizontal lines left behind. Larger etching than with the pulse machine. And actually, not too hot. All the rust is removed. The biggest difference is the etching compared to the pulse machine. Now let's see how the FLC2000 handles this heavy surface rust with pitting. The rust was gone in a few seconds. Now I'm just having fun burning off all this old paint and primer. Here's the result close up, done in a fraction of the time of the pulse machine. Both the pulsed and continuous wave machines struggle with this bracket due to the white paint, and white is going to be an issue with any laser machine. But the bare rusty surface was cleaned, and eventually the FLC2000 did begin to remove the white paint. I'm kind of surprised that's not more hot. Here's a close-up. The top edge, where the laser was hitting straight on, had a lot more paint removed than the vertical sides. Now it was time to revisit the stubborn swing arm. The width of this laser made it easy for cleaning the outside, but the pulsed laser is really better for reaching all of the inside edges. I forgot to turn the fan on here, so it's making quite the smoke show. So, I still have some of that burnt residue left behind on the surface. You can see it does come off a little easier, probably thanks to the heat from this laser. Where there was a machine surface instead of a cast texture, the powder coating came right off and didn't leave any burnt residue. That's super clean. But over here, it had the same issue as the pulsed laser. Let's take one more look at that. This came out a little cleaner if I spent the extra time on it with the pulsed machine in cycle ring mode. I'd still love to know what kind of powder coating this is. And here's a bonus, rusty steel oil pan. While both machines have their advantages, it really comes down to what type of items you'll be cleaning. The FLC2000 will save a whole lot of time cleaning larger items, while the FLC200 is much more precise with more adjustable parameters and 8 different cleaning modes. Ideal for smaller or more delicate items without causing any damage to the original substrate underneath. As far as fun goes, imagine driving a 200 horsepower car and then driving a 2000 horsepower car. The FLC2000 is so powerful, and I'll be making a full video all about its advantages and disadvantages when the weather warms up. That's one of the disadvantages. It can't be used in cold temperatures. I thank you for watching this channel, which has allowed me to have one of each of these machines to restore my rusty vehicles with the latest cutting-edge technology. Now I must go edit this video on my 2013 iMac. Thanks for watching.